Let's define reason as a power whose function is to find truth. This will in fact be our very first principle of philosophy. Reason finds truth. Why? Exactly. For to ask the question why is to ask for a good reason. And as all reasoning comes from our power of reason, this question presupposes that reason finds truth. The belief in this claim will be our one and only act of blind faith. Reason finds truth. And any attempts to defend it would be in vain. Reason is divided into two types: inductive reasoning or induction, and deductive reasoning or deduction. Induction is described as inference to the most reasonable explanation or outcome. Note that this specific type of induction is also sometimes called abductive reasoning or abduction, but as this name is not as common, we will continue to call it induction. Induction is also closely associated with one of the first principles of metaphysics and epistemology, the principle of sufficient reason. Everything that exists or is true requires a sufficient reason to exist or to be true. Let's show what this means. We will start with induction about finding the most reasonable explanation. Upon observation of data, as represented here as data points, we attempt to give a possible explanation. The explanation may not be less than what is sufficient, otherwise it fails to account for all the data. On the other hand, the explanation may not be more than what is sufficient, otherwise some of its parts are not supported by the data. The explanation must be just sufficient. This criteria is sometimes referred to as Occam's razor. Choose the simplest explanation that accounts for all the data, which is a specific case of the more general principle, sufficient reason. For example, let's say that all the swans we have ever observed so far are white. We offer two possible explanations: all swans in the world are white, and some swans are white and some are not. Both explanations sufficiently account for all the data, but the second explanation, with its second part, is more than sufficient. It is superfluous. And so, the first explanation is the most reasonable one. This does not mean that the second explanation is necessarily false, only that it is less reasonable given the data we currently have. But now, if the next one we observe turns out not to be white, this time neither explanation is more than sufficient. But the first explanation no longer sufficiently accounts for all the data. And so the second explanation becomes the most reasonable one. When it comes to finding the most reasonable outcome, we fulfill the sufficient reason criteria by choosing the outcome that is the most probable, usually found through statistics. For example, when selecting at random, there is a higher probability of selecting a white swan. So, if we had to make a prediction, we would choose a white swan as the most reasonable outcome. Both outcomes are possible, but a higher probability provides a sufficient reason to tip the scale. Deduction is inference to the necessary outcome. It is also closely associated with the other first principle of metaphysics and epistemology, logic. A thing is what it is, not what it is not, and there is no in-between. An outcome is necessary if a concept cannot be imagined without it. Consider object A sitting inside set B, as represented in this Venn diagram. We would say that A is B. If A is inside B, then we cannot imagine it to be outside at the same time. Likewise, if A is not inside B, that is, A is not B, then we cannot imagine it to be inside at the same time. And even if A is partially inside B, then the part that is inside is not outside, and vice versa. This is a graphical representation of the laws of logic. A thing is what it is, not what it is not, and there is no in-between. Note that this is not a proof of the principle. How could you wish to prove first principles, you fools? But it shows that our imagination is strongly associated with deduction and logic. This test of imagination also works with mathematics, which is the science of logic of numbers. 2 plus 2 necessarily equals 4 because we cannot imagine 2 plus 2 without imagining 4, or 1 plus 3, or 2 plus 1 plus 1, and so on. Note that we can't say or write 2 plus 2 equals 3, but we cannot imagine it, let alone produce it in reality. This is why this statement is always false. It cannot conform to reality. A triangle necessarily has three sides because we cannot imagine a triangle without imagining three sides. And likewise, if we imagine more or less than three sides, then we no longer imagine a triangle. Deduction is also commonly used for simple propositions, as represented as Venn diagrams, like so. All A's are B's, some A's are B's, no A's are B's. So, if all A's are B's, and all B's are C's, then all A's are C's. We cannot imagine it any other way. For example, if all swans are white, and all white things are bright, then all swans are bright. If all A's are B's, and no B's are C's, then no A's are C's. If some A's are B's, and all B's are C's, then at least some A's are C's. And so, implementation of reason is a back and forth between induction and deduction following observations. For a complete example, let's go back to the reasoning made in the previous video on the leap of faith, where we said, if all the verifiable claims from a source are verified to be true, then it is reasonable to infer that the remaining unverifiable claims from that source are also true. Let's break down this argument into its reasoning types. We start with induction following the observation that all the verifiable claims from a source are verified to be true. We offer two possible explanations. All the claims from the source are true, and some claims from the source are true and some are false. Both explanations sufficiently account for all the data, but the second explanation, with its second part, is more than sufficient. It is superfluous. Thus, the first explanation is the most reasonable one. Now, on to deduction using a Venn diagram. If it is reasonable to believe that all the claims from a source are true, and all the unverifiable claims are from that same source, then it is reasonable to believe that all the unverifiable claims are true. In the next video, we will use our reason to defend specific positions in the form of arguments. See you then. Thanks for watching.